the current numbers, the numbers for the quarter gone by have been a little soft, but the company has shown a lot of intangible qualities which make for perhaps a recovering story, as we have been highlighting the fact that they have been employing more, and I think the number of clients as well, really a shade lower. There doesn't seem to be anything negative in terms of client acquisition, and clearly the company is positive enough to promise double-digit growth, so 10-12%. Again, guidance below NASCOM, we've been saying that, but about their own historical performance. At this point in time, the stock is down just about 1%. Okay, so for once, it's not reacting very, very wild gyrations after the announcement of the numbers. Any thoughts? I think the stock will, at the moment, not need to react much to the numbers?
Yeah, I thought it would still be relatively stable. I think post the earnings call which they are posting today, and post the media and the press interactions, I probably think that today would be a more relevant day to watch how the individual funds stock behaves, because post the earnings call today, I think the street and the analysts will have a better handle in terms of what precisely this growth translates into terms of earnings growth and what the outlook is, not just for 1 year, but maybe for the next couple of years. So I think that tomorrow is probably a more important day, the next training day is going to be probably important than what's going to happen in the next one.
For the moment, you feel the numbers are stably priced. Yeah, I think there will be a mild variation.
Absolutely, because I think the Q4 numbers, I think to some extent, are not very relevant. They were probably the last thing that the street was focused on. There is more about what's the guidance for next year.
That's coming at the other end of it.
That's coming in line at least with expectations. At least this is the basis that we have needed. There is some improvement on some of the operating parameters, so that has been a positive sign. We've seen the new management go out and be more aggressive in terms of acquisitions. So I think on the whole, overall, I think it needs to be a reasonably kind of stable set of numbers and outlook. What is going to be important is now what we the street takes from 1 to 2 year perspective in terms of growth.
After the management speak, I would assume. Well, Sandeep Agarwal of ADWise Financial Services, welcome to class. Sandeep, you heard the numbers and you heard what we may have to say. What are your thoughts about the numbers? Would you be worried about the miss on several fronts?
Yes, the quarterly numbers obviously are below estimate. We were expecting at least 40-50% kind of growth in dollar terms, implying 2.5% kind of growth in constant currency. But you know, the numbers have shown at 2.7% kind of decline from dollar terms. So it is below our estimate, obviously, and even PAT and margins are also below. But the good thing is that, you know, the key metrics of the business is to start with guidance. I think guidance is slightly higher than what we were expecting. In fact, we were expecting 7-9 in dollar terms. And this looks like slightly higher than that, maybe 7.5-9.5, assuming that, you know, there will be 250 basis points on the impact of currency. Other thing to note is I have limited time to see all the numbers, but, you know, the attrition number looks like 13.4%. I think that is a very, very important and good number to look at. It is really, really very nice metric to see, because, you know, this company has been suffering from very high attrition for the past 7 quarters.
Sandeep, come back to you in just a minute, because Trip Chaudhary is on the line from San Francisco and we're going to wait a bit. Okay, I think we'll have to cut across now to Vishal Sikka himself. Trip, we'll come back to you as soon as Dr. Sikka finishes speaking.
But I want to make a few minutes to outline my thought on the year behind us and our outlook on the road ahead of us.